So I have a bunch of tricks with me. So seated at the front of whatever chair you have. I'm going to use my TheraBand. I happen to have a long one. If you do not, you can use a shorter one. By the way, if you guys do want to purchase these from us, you can always maybe figure something out, just contact us. So I started with feet down. Nick's probably like, what? Started with feet down, chest up, spine is tall. TheraBand is going to be around my hand. Looks like bicep curl. Now, so I'm seated at the front of my chair. In six, you should feel that tension. And five, and four, and three, and two. Let's hold it in there, take a little pump in. You do not have a band, you can use weights. You have a ball only. Put that ball between your knees right now. Five, four, three, two, good. I'm gonna go into B feet. So I just went to my heel to start. Palms facing down, if you have that TheraBand, arms go out. Again, you can place the ball between your knees. But this is a great tool. This is a lot in PT, it's a really good strengthener. I'm sure that I've gotten so used to using them that when you get back in the studio, I will probably be incorporating that in. Five, and four, and three, and two, and good. Going to those toes. I just lift it up onto my high heel. Look back and put those palms towards one another. Tip forward, halfway down, extend it up. Down, extend it up. So anything that's going to give you tension. I just had to check my own form. I separated those knees. Four. Three and two. Let's go up a little bit higher and hold those arms out. You're holding weights, just holding the tension on that weight. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Feet, feet up on the toes. The palms facing in. Let's go ahead and extend up and down. Up and down. Starting off with arm work. We are going to do some standing work in just a minute. In five and four, and three, and two, and good. Take that down. We're going to use that band later on. If you have one, or if you have a ball, so keep that near you. If you have weights or cans, we're going to grab those. We can start out, put both those hands apart. Weights are in my hands, or cans are in your hands. Just raise up under high heel. Rock it back onto your toes. Raise up, rock it back. Four and three and two and good. I'm going to go and take it out into a wide, wide, wide squat. Palms facing up. Extend those arms out. Take it down to your feet. Raise and lower. Up and down. This is going to count to footwork. In six. In five. In four, I was going to do this with just a little hand, and three, and two, hold it down there, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, replace your weights down, going into an internal rotation, toes facing inward, take it down into a seat, palms are going to face back on this one, just pump it back, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, back to parallel feet, down into a seat, extend those weights up, drop down. So I'm staying in that squatted position. Four, six, and five, and four, and three, and two, hold it up there. Squeeze, hold, engage on those triceps. Five, four, three, two. Shake out those legs. Let's go into a turnout. Palms are going to face you. Second position feet, take down into a plie. Raise those arms up, up and down. in and out. So when I'm doing these, I want you to think about squeezing those shoulder blades together, elbows up and down. I just brought my turnout in just a tiny bit, kind of like when you keep moving, kind of like when you guys are on the reformer, and I'll adjust some of your feet. My rotation, if you are too overly extended, not going to feel nice on your knees. I feel like I should be doing like a yeehaw. 5, 4, 3, 2. Let's flip those weights. Palms are facing one another. Stay down into your seat. Stay down there to hold the tension on the weight. Little press is down. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Good. Set your weights to the side. Moving on in your series. You're going to take that chair. Coming into either your forearms or your wrists, just like you would on the box. Hold the plank. Elbows or wrists, either way. Push those hips down, shoulders down. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Good, and then one half. Coming down onto your knees. I want you to extend your knees back. Hands go onto the chair wide. Push-ups. In and out. So my elbows are going out. This is kind of the equivalent of when we're on the box. So fingertips are kind of facing in. They're not like this. 4, 3, and 2. Good, come on out. Child's pose back. Second set, tricep press. Elbows in close to that rib cage. Take it down, push off. Take it down, push off. So elbows are trying to glide to the side of your rib. No, but feet are up, please. Belly's pulled in. 4 and 3. Go to bridge series next. And 2. And if you have a ball, or if you have a thin area and you want to make it harder, bring around there. If you have a TheraBand, you are wrapping it around the external part of the knees, above the knees. You have a ball, I'm going to take my ball. We'll place that in between my knees, face up, heels on. I'm just squeezing into that ball. I'm going to lift up and lower it down. Very lower. Up and down. So I've heard instructors different on how they like breath work. I prefer inhale lift, exhale lower. I like to exhale lower because I feel like you can get abdominal contraction. 4. You can also be doing this just on the mat or on the carpet. Whatever you're working with at home. 3. Squeeze at the top. 2. Good. Squeeze hold. I just squeeze my ball a little bit deeper. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And good. All right. Coming on down. If you have that band, you know where it is. You have a ball. I want you to reach up and begin to pump those arms. We're going to do the 100. Just with your feet on a chair, but let's use your jump ball for. Push out those knees. Inhale 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale. Add front. Oh, do 100. Inhale. Exhale. Push that back down. Inhale. Exhale. 42, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If you want to make this harder, lift up those feet. Try to keep your rib cage pulled in for me. Counting down. This is 60, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 70. Pull that air in, blow it out. Pull that air in, blow it out. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, extend a little bit deeper, a little bit higher. 5, 4, 3, three, two. Bring those feet back down. Rest in your neck. Lift up and hold. We engage in a golf clap. Four, three, two, and good. Long seated. Get your ball out of the way. Get that out of the way. If you have your chair out in front of you, I want you to extend your legs up. Take a stretch. For the back of the hamstrings or the back of the calves, or something, you might be all the way down here. I'm going to release my hands. I'm going to hold the teeth there. Five, four, as you scooped in. Three, two, come on up, spine stretch. One more time, take it down. And five, and four, and three, and two, spine stretch forward. Last one, chest up, palms facing one another. Five, four, three, two, pull the leg up. Five, four, three, two, good. All right. Get your chair just out of the way. We're going to use that later on to stretch. If you have a band or a ball, you're going to grab that. I'm going to take my band and I'm going to wrap it around my back. Legs are bent. Once you round down, touch on that band, lift up, come up nice and tall. We're going to add it in just a minute. Lift up nice and tall. Four. Keep your balance. The belly sucked in. And three. Inhale. And two. Hold it down there. Get a soft bend in the nose. Open it out. Close it back in. So hugging your tree. Four, three, two, and good. I'm going to take that band. You have a good night. You're going to melt the band today. Place it around that foot. We're going to lay it on down. Put it resting to start. So take a leg first. I just put that right on. I should have been flexing my heel. Opposite leg extended, or it can be bent. Go ahead, lift the head down. Pull tension on that. Raise lower, up and down. Look at Huey, big flex in that heel. I'm doubled up on my band. Elbows are bent. Four, three, two. Let's raise the head up. You need to support. You can make it harder. Opposite foot is up. That bothers the back. So advanced, medium, mild. Four, three, two. Okay, I'm going to end my knee just because my back started to talk a little bit. I'm very tight today. Toes are going to face in. Doubling up on that mat. I'm resting my head in this one. Up and down. Five. Four and three and two. Let's go to an external rotation. Neck, leg can be wherever you want it. And head can be up or down on this one. Driving from that flex. This is round one of leg work. We're doing quite a bit. Four, three, two. Come back into center. I want you to bend that knee in, head again, rest if you want. Works different parts. This to me is a little bit more low core, which is always nice. This is full rectus abdominis, so your front facing abs, but my back is imprinted because my head is up. Push you down. Five, and four, and three, and two. Internal rotation. Knee doesn't like that, but just get here, okay? Resting my head. My back's starting to get a little bit tired. Four, three, two. Let's go to an external rotation. Half frog leg. Five, four, three, two. Both feet come into your band, or your legs are extended up. I just doubled up on my band. Resting my head, both legs come halfway down, extend up to the bottom of your back. four, three, two. Switch legs. Legs lower up and down again. We'll let that flex drive you down. After we did this last threaded footage chair in the front of the floor. Pull up. Like I felt it the next day. Three, two, internal rotation. Toes facing in. We'll make it harder. Single arm. Three, two, external rotation. Again, right knee bent, right knee up. Whatever feels better, right knee up. Go on, cast the side. Lots of options. Three, two, good, parallel, and hand out. And then neck is tired, rest it. You want to double up. Your hands are tired. Right, left, left, five, four, three, two, internal, I'm going to rest my head, my neck's getting tired, four, three, two, final in the series, external rotation, heel lead, five, four, three, two, both feet go in. Let's take a stretch up. Loosen up on that band just a little bit. If you do not have a band, if you have a ball, I can separate my legs a little bit. Hip width distance apart. I'm going to double up back on that. Lower those legs down. Head just came up. Forehead to rest. You're going to bend in and out. Five. Four. Three. Two, and good, come on up. I want you to draw those hands toward you. Take a stretch. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Set that band to the side if you have one. And we're going to grab your weight or ball or your hand, whatever you have. Or if you're still on kneeling armor, you can also be seated armor. Okay, palms facing up, we're going to take presentation series. So lift up and lower down. Exhale, lift. So what I want you to check right now is, are your knees wider than your hips? So hip bones, you guys, I just pulled mine in. What's beautiful about the camera I have in here is that I can see the hip weight. I can stand. So this is what I see on your forearms. You bat a lot. Pull in your belly. Up. Have a slight bend. Open out. Four. Three. Two. Good. Just hold it up there. Bicep curls. In and out. Elbows up. Nice and high. Four. Three. Two, and good. Let's lift those palms. Soft bend in those elbows, open out. Again, you can be seated, or you can be down. That's kind of a nice break. But if you're up, this is the hardest advanced version. Might as well push yourself today. And friend or activist, I said, if you want to go, a walk or a run this afternoon. I was like, ah. She's like, you said not to let you fail. So yeah, don't fail on this one. Four. Probably keeping you safe, make sure it's me. Three. Two. Good. Both those arms. Palms facing up. I just align those elbows with my shoulders. Palms out. Up and down. This is getting too much on the shoulders. Do it with no weight, no tension. In those biceps, triceps. Four, three, two. Let's close those elbows in, open them up. Your arms should be starting to burn right now. Four, three, two, and good. Set those weights to the side, get them out of your way. If you have a ball, I want you you're at it. If not, it's not a big deal, but maybe you have a pillow or something. I'm going to take that ball and my chair out of it. I'm going to place it underneath my chest. If you've had any surgeries and the spot of it, move the ball all together. Just make it a little bit harder. I'm going to take Superman. You can do reverse Superman if you like. Inhale back, lift up. Inhale back, my shoulders are pointed. Glutes are engaged. Four. Up for three. Up for two. Last one, let's hold it up there. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Push your hands by your side. I want you to lift up, press into those palms. Lift off the ball. Lift up the pillow. Four, three, two, take it down. One more, push up. Five, four, three, two, and good. If you have a ball, we're gonna do some ab work. You're gonna place it underneath the tailbone. If not, I want you to support your hands underneath your tailbone. So legs are gonna face up on the mat for it. Ball underneath my sacrum. Let's go ahead and I want you to draw a little circle in the sky. Five, four, three, two, minor, and seven, one, done. Reverse that. Five, four, so we're in there, three, two. Let's extend one leg down and bring it up. Opposite leg up and bring it up. Does ever a strain on your back again? You can be supported. Just keep your hands and legs are pointed, toes are pointed. So on Monday's class, if we're doing my 11:30 fundamentals class, doing the fundamental principles of Pilates, we are going to be working on precision. So I want you to notice when you are doing precise, boom, big point on the toes, precise. Not just flopping around, four. And four, and three, and three, and two, even yourself out. I'm kind of off kilter. Last one, legs straight up at 90 degrees, but not lower, I just strain my back. We're also not past my hip. Feet legs together, let's hook a little hold up, up, low core, lift it. Up for eight, up for seven, up for six, up for five, up for four, up for three, up for two, and good. Let's lift off that ball and come seated. Set your ball to the side. If you have your there, band, you're going to grab onto that. I'm extending my there band out in front of me. I'm going to take that out to the side. If I want to make that harder, I come closer, right? So chest is up to start. Four. Three. Two. Good. And four halfway down. Just a little bit. I do my feet in a little bit. Come up tall. So put tension on. Separate those arms out to the side. Come up tall on the spine. Round down a bit. Lift up and forward. Two more. Last set. Just land down there. Curl that middle knee. Take little pumps out. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Good. Set your hands to the side. Shake out those hands. Grab water if you need it. We're going to keep moving. So, coming onto your knees, or you could be standing. We're going to do side series. So I'm on my knees, but you can always do the standing if this bothers your knees. Hands stacked underneath. Those shoulders, I'm gonna extend one leg out. Take that out back at an angle, pull it in. I'm gonna bring it over here so you guys can see. Extend out, flex that heel. Try not to collapse on one side. Try to really draw that knee in. How about we go four, 10, 9, 8, 7, try to keep those hips flat, 6, 5, 4, inner outer thighs working, 3, 2, extend it out, lengthen that out, keep that flex in that foot, let's pump it up, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, switch to talking, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, draw that knee into your elbow, okay? Point that toe, extend to arabesque. Inhale in, exhale, lengthen it. Inhale in, exhale, lengthen it. So pulling that breath in, pulling that core in. Four, 10, and 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, this is 4, this is 3, this is 2, hold it up there, point that toe, hold 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, shake out those wrists. Let's take it down onto your knees, or you're just taking a rest break, grab water if you need it. Just give me the wrist a break for a second. Come on up. All right, other side. Knee comes in, out to an angle, flex that heel. So my foot is slightly angled. Just about, not even, less than 15 minutes left of class. Breathing. Okay, hold it out there, flex that heel, press it. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Big flex in that heel, though, foot's angled. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, draw that in. Flex it out, draw it in. Flex it out. You want to flex on this one? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, switch to a point, draw it in, hold it out there, I know I did a point in the opposite one, hold it out there, hold, 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 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, good, take it down, child's pose, rest you out, 5, 4, 3, 2, and good. Let's get you off of your knees. Legs extended out. Let's reach down for those legs. Grab your band if you have it. We're going to extend. Grab that band around the feet. I want you to take a stretch for those Achilles and come up nice and tall. Okay, palms are going to face up. If you have weights instead, you want to use those, that's fine. Don't keep yourself in the face. It's a very bad idea. I thought I was going to break it. You're like, okay, palms raise your nose. If I accidentally look, who cares about me? Ah, the joys. The joys. 5, 4, 3, 2, round down and back. Lift up, present your chest. Down and back. Lift up and lengthen. Yeah, please be careful. Don't hit yourself in the face like I did. I have a very good record of people not breaking anything in my class, except for me. 2. Last one. Hold it back there. Little presses. 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, and good. I think that's enough arm work for today. Let's take it standing, grabbing on to your chair. So hopefully your chair is nice and sturdy. We're gonna do side series. You can be stacked, you can be on your wrist, holding the side plank, or you can be on that elbow, like that, or you can be like this. If you're like that, that, so you have your hands over. I'm gonna come up onto my wrist. I'd like to be staggered, exactly. Those of you that wanna add on. Internal rotation, external rotation. Always options. Or you can stay here. You can also raise and lower. How about we do 10 seconds? This is the advanced version here. 5, 4, 3, 2, let's take a spine stretch. So bring those hands forward, push it down, and let's go to the other side for me. All right, timer starts. Again, staggered for me, but some people like to stack. I never feel secure that way. Up, down, forward, over, or on your elbow. Lots of options here. Let's go, 4. Just about 20 seconds left. And you can hold. Breathing. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, shake those wrists out if you are on your wrist. Take it down, child's pose. Okay, we're going to take it all the way down onto the floor. I just extended my legs back behind me. I'm holding on. You can hold on to the base of the chair. Lift up into that spine. And the more you push it out, the more length you're going to get in your spine. I want you to push that barbell away. Lift up your chest. I just drop my feet down on this one. Inhale back down. Squat and chest. So I'm putting tension. A little bit different than squat and mat, you would be kind of like pushing down a little bit. The squat on the chair, you would be pushing the pedal down. Now, if you guys have a folding chair, you can do that. But I'm assuming that people really might not, so hands wide of those legs. 4. And 3. For your back, arms, belly, low back. Let's extend it up there. I want you to rest that head down, but lift those feet up. 8, 7. 6, toes are pointed, good kick edge. 5, 4, 3, 2, draw your hands into your side, push yourself up, coming on to all fours. Let's round it in and up. Neutral, stick your butt out, round it in and up. Neutral, 2 more. Last one. We're just going to do a little bit of work. You can be standing or kneeling. We're going to do some inner outer thigh work. All I want to do today is prior hydrant. So raising that up, pointing that toe. Try to get your hip up there. Try not to land to one side. If your foot cramps, I want you to go to flex for me. 30 seconds from here. I'm going to point today. Again, not leaning. So full minute. And after this, we get to stretch. We have to do both sides. You can be on your fists if you want. 15 seconds. 10 seconds. We'll shake out those wrists in 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Rest it down. Child's pose. Shake out those wrists. Let's come right back up. We have one more minute. Other side. Up and down. Timer has started. You get to stretch after this. The more you engage that glute, harder it's going to be. Better for you it's going to be. Again, don't jut your hip out. You have just about 30 seconds. Up and up and up. Almost there. Almost there. Counting down, this is 20, up for 19, up for 18, quick hit, 17, 16, 15, up 14, 13, 12, 11, this is 10, and the countdown, 9, 8, 7, 6, and five, and four, and three, and two. Beautiful. Okay, let's begin to stretch you up. If you have that band, keep your chair close to you because I'm gonna try to finish with my band on the chair. If you have a band or anything that can lengthen you out, I'm gonna flip my foot into my band. I'm gonna cross that over my body, flexing that heel. Gaze can go to the opposite side, or you can do the center band. You can also open up that arm, come into center, open it up to the side, and if I stretch, hamstring stretch. Come back into center, one more time, cross over, IT band stretch. You can also get that shoulder stretch. Open it out. Come into center. We'll take both feet in. Hold your flex stretch. Four, three, two. I want you to take that same leg that's working. Cross it over your knee. You can either bend in or extend it up. So we're going to do different things. So when I extend this in, and I'm in my figure four stretch, I get that in that piriformis muscle, glute muscle, really tight on me today. And if I extend it here, I get a nice hamstring calf stretch, which I'm also tight. So it's all good. Let's switch legs, pull that leg out, flex that heel, cross it over. Open that out. Cross it over. Open it out. Come into the center. Again, both feet in. Cross that leg over. Bend it in. Whatever feels better. I'm having a lot of IT band issues lately, so this to me feels really nice. Five, four, three, two, and good. Set your band, whatever you're using, off to the side. I want to take a seat it on the chair or mermaid specialist. Good turn so you guys can see me. So I have one leg extended out, one knee is bent. You see some instructors will teach you this way. Different versions. Extend over, hold. But that leg is out, toes on the ground. Why? Because I want to stretch out the whole side of my hip. Maybe go a little bit deeper so I can lengthen out and that feel nice. Four, three, two, come seated, and I want you to do Delman's cross. Cross that over. I'm going to push my knee down slightly. Five, four, three, two, shake those legs up. Go to the other side. I just adjust myself on my chair. Again, lengthen out, reach over, hold. Five, four, three, two, come on up. I can't remember if I did one or two. Let's do it one more time. The force it does feels really good. Five, four, three, two, cross over. Again, you want to add on, push that knee open just a little bit. You saw me just adjust myself because that felt better. I wanted more of a stretch on this hip. Five, four, three, two. I'm seated. I just went to the move to the front of my chair. I want you to round down. Try to interlace those hands or interlace your elbows. Round down, shelf pose. Hold your low back stretch. Five, four, three, two. Come up nice and tall. Take an inhale breath. Reach over, interlace those hands. Over one wrist. Reach over, hold. Try to get some length into your ribcage. Four, three, two, coming to center, other side. Five, four, three, two. Change wrists again, one more time. I want you to take those hands back behind you, pop those ribs open. Switch wrists, pop those wrists open, take a stretch in the tricep. Interlacing your hands back behind you, chest expansion, pushing that chest forward. 5, 4, 3, 2, maybe a little bit higher. A little bit higher to open up my pecs, a little bit deeper. 4, 3, 2, we did a lot of arm work today. 1, shake out those arms. Go ahead and cross one arm over. Shoulder stretch. 5, 4, 3, 2, tricep stretch. 5, 4, 3, 2, shake them out, other side. That should open up that deltoid very nicely. Deltoid rotator cuff, tricep, bicep, it's a stretch here. Yeah, tricep. Shake out those arms, let's finish with hip stretches. So we're just gonna come off the chair. Legs extended forward, I want you to simply jog your hips out. Rock it over to one side, push your hips back behind. Other side, come forward. Last roll down, front of reach bowl. So tall, left side, right to the right. Bowing down with your head, shoulders and chest, reach to the floor. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, soft bend of the knee, second left side. Come on up, nice and tall.